Time to play Name of the Game. It is our speed quiz with questions related to the year that we were talking about in Throwback Thursday. And today the answer was 1973.
Mm-hmm.
Well done on getting that, by the way.
Yeah.
Well done on knowing what year your celebrity crush was born.
Yes, Jung Woo-sung. He was all the rage when I was growing up.
He's still very handsome.
Yep.
I know his name, of course, but where do we see him these days?
He's doing a lot of movies recently. I can't really name one, although.
Ah, not so much the mega fan after all.
Yeah,
huh?
Just the photos, I guess.
Yeah, 1973. You said the clue about the Vietnam War, right?
Yes.
That America withdrew from Vietnam in this year?
Yes, they signed the Paris Peace Accords.
Yeah, I thought it was 72 or 73. My guess was 72. Yeah, and then that went on for a couple of more years till 75, right?
Yeah, the actual, like, there was, like, here and there stuff.
Yeah. And then that's what I learned when I was there, that Saigon was the name before 1975, but the name Ho Chi Minh City was given to Saigon after the end of the war because the North won.
Mm-hmm.
I did not know that.
Yeah, I didn't know that either.
I thought Saigon's not a city anymore?
No, it is. It's just, it goes by both names now, right? But I believe the official name of the city is Ho Chi Minh City.
Oh, okay.
But in Ho Chi Minh City, people call it Saigon. Because the name was given to them.
Oh, right.
Saigon's in the south. Yeah.
Okay.
You have to go there. It's an amazing place.
I've been there, but it was so young. I don't remember.
Go again. Yeah. Go again. 1973. This is going to be a challenging name of the game today. JY, would you like to go first or second today?
I'll go first because I've been fearing this moment from the beginning when I heard Jung Woo-sung's ear, but I'll go first and see what's up.
10 questions about Jung Woo-sung, maybe.
Hopefully, yes.
I don't know that much about him.
60 seconds on the clock. 10 questions for JY from the year 1973.
Time starts now.
American rock band with Steven Tyler releases their debut album. What is the band?
Oh, Steven Tyler. Oh, pass.
Okay. King of Rock and Roll's concert in Hawaii is watched by more people than the Apollo moon landings. Who was it?
King of Rock and Roll. The pass.
Okay. President of the Watergate scandal is sworn in for a second term as president of the United
States. Richard Nixon.
Okay. Case where the U.S. Supreme Court overturns state ban on abortion. What was it called?
Jim Crow? No, not Jim Crow. Pass.
Okay. George Foreman defeats blank to win the heavyweight world boxing championship.
Beats blank?
What's his name?
Pass.
Okay. Animated movie about a spider is released.
It's spider? Charlie. No. Charlotte's Web?
Yes, right. Okay. Pink Floyd's album with a prism on the cover, one of rock's landmark albums, is released. What's it called?
Pink Floyd?
Yes. What's the name of the album?
Pink Floyd. No.
No.
No? Okay, pass.
Okay. Elizabeth II officially opens this bridge in England.
Oh, brutal. Oh, man.
It's not that hard, is it?
I'm like blinking.
You got two.
Charlotte, I don't know.
That was a hard one.
My goodness. Jim Crow, what's up?
Jim Crow, that's not it.
I know.
That's like the segregation
thing. It's just like one of the major, versus.
It's a lot of pressure when that clock is ticking. Okay, let's go through and see if I can get some points.
All right. I feel like you are going to. But American rock band with Steven Tyler.
Aerosmith.
Aerosmith is correct. King of Rock and Roll's concert in Hawaii is watched by more people than the Apollo moon landings.
Elvis Presley.
That's right.
All right, you got the Richard Nixon one. The case where the U.S. Supreme Court overturned state ban on abortion.
Yeah, Wade versus Roe?
Yes.
Wow,
okay. George Foreman defeats blank to win the heavyweight world boxing championship.
It was a very
famous match.
Yeah, was it Muhammad Ali?
No.
Let me guess again. I won't take the point. This wasn't the fight in Africa, was it?
I don't think so.
Joe Frazier?
It was.
Wow. Steve.
All right, you got Charlie's Web.
Charlotte's Web.
Charlotte's Web. Pink Floyd's album with a prism on the cover.
Dark Side of the Moon.
Dark Side of the Moon. Elizabeth II, Queen Elizabeth II, officially opens this famous bridge in England.
Well, the name that comes to mind, obviously, is the... not my answer, Kiana. The London Bridge, but I don't...
Oh.
You're right.
I'll take a half point for that one.
Film about mobsters wins Best Picture at the Academy Awards.
Mobsters.
Mobsters in 1973.
Hmm.
The Godfather came the out before Godfather.
Oh, what? Mm-hmm. Steve.
This New York building becomes the tallest building, and then in parentheses S, in the world.
Hmm.
Oh, in parentheses S?
Yeah.
Tallest buildings.
The Twin Towers?
That's right. Huh? The Twin Towers. What? The World Trade Center. Oh. Although one technically was taller because of the spite, the, you know, the antenna, mm-hmm. but, you know, they're still the tallest. Oh. Yeah, so you got like 8 points or something,
two.
Seven,
yeah,
something like that.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.5. I'm only taking a half for London Bridge.
Mm-hmm. All right.
I was such a noob in New York. I was walking down the street with my friend from New York who lives there,
mm-hmm.
you know, went to like Times Square, and I was like, oh, cool, you know, like, oh, there's Times Square. We're walking down that street that goes away from Times Square. I look off in the distance at the super tall building, right? And I go, uh-huh. oh, that's nice. What's that? And she goes, the Empire State Building.
It's not that far from Times Square, isn't
know,
it?
It's
like
not, but
two or three blocks.
I thought it would be a lot more grandiose.
Yeah,
it's huge.
It is huge, but it was far away.
Oh,
no,
yeah.
Anyway, I felt like an idiot. deservedly so. All right, we'll have our second round after Jacoby Couch Potato. I was thinking during that break, you know, in American cinematic film history, they kind of call The Godfather the greatest movie ever made, mm-hmm. right? Uh-huh. And I think that that still kind of holds that title.
Right.
So I was, ever made or in that genre?
Well, I think they kind of put it up there as one of the best movies ever made. If you look at the mm-hmm. top 10 lists of best movies ever,
yeah.
according to America, of course, Hollywood, I mean,
mm-hmm.
then The Godfather is going to be near the top of the list, if not at the top of
yeah.
the list,
yeah.
I think.
I think that's indisputable.
That's what I was thinking of two things during that song break. I wonder if that will ever be replaced by anything else. And number two, is there a Korean equivalent where people in Korea say, oh, this Korean movie was the greatest Korean movie ever?
Hibaraki.
Yeah, Hibaraki. No, Jeong the movie, not really. I think they look to Bong Joon-ho's movie a lot, like Sarin
oh,
Chuo.
Yeah.
Those are relatively new.
Yeah,
though.
Relatively new. I think old times.
Taegukki.
No, maybe something from the 70s, but not sure.
Mm.
All right, let's get back to it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.5 points on the board for me, 2 for JY. It is my turn?
Yes,
it's
your
is.
Turn. Yeah, my turn.
Yes.
60 seconds on the clock. 10 more questions about the year 1973.
Time starts now.
This tall landmark in Chicago is completed.
Oh, yeah, pass.
Okay, this famous martial artist and movie star dies in this year.
Bruce Lee?
Yes. This singer releases his most successful album, Goodbye Yellow Brick Road.
Goodbye. Elton John.
Yes, Elton John is correct. East and West Germany admitted to this worldwide organization.
Admitted to, like, pass.
Like, okay. America launches its first space station called...
Oh, pass.
Okay. This tall, famous landmark in Toronto begins construction.
Oh, yeah. What's that called?
I put it there for you, man.
I know, right? Pass.
Okay.
CN Tower.
Yes,
CN Tower.
Tower.
Yeah, right.
This movie about being possessed is released. What is that movie?
Poltergeist?
No. This famous artist dies in France. Very famous.
Andy Warhol?
No. Okay. The daughter of Queen Elizabeth gets married.
True.
What's her name? You don't know?
The daughter of Queen Elizabeth.
The second.
Nah, I don't know.
Oh.
I don't know. Oh, what a horrible round.
Oh, you better hope she doesn't know these.
Well, hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.5. So you need 7.5 to
wow.
tie.
Wow.
I was kind of hoping
the numbers are there.
The CN Tower, I literally put that there for you.
I know. My mind is blank. The Chicago one is driving me crazy. Okay, go ahead. See if you can see what you're
doing. This tall landmark in Chicago is completed.
Is it like a brand name? No.
No, it's not.
Okay, I pass.
It's not the Sears Tower?
It is the Sears Tower.
Oh.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Okay.
But I don't think that's the brand name, is it?
Sears is,
oh,
yeah. Mm-hmm. Department store.
Oh, we don't have it here, though. So.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, you got Bruce Lee. You got Elton John. All right. East and West Germany admitted to this worldwide organization.
Is it UN?
The UN is correct.
Okay.
I was thinking admitted to something, like to admit to something.
Oh.
Okay, my fault. My fault.
America launches its first space station called...
Space station. No clue.
It is called the Skylab.
Oh, never heard that
Oh, you guys
before.
Have never heard about
no.
that?
No.
The famous tall landmark in Toronto begins construction. That's, oh, you got that
no,
one.
No, it's CN Tower.
This movie about being possessed is released.
Exorcist.
The Exorcist.
Yeah, right. What was Poltergeist about?
That came out like way later, I think.
Yeah, I think you're right. Yeah, I didn't like The Exorcist.
I didn't like the Poltergeist. I thought The Exorcist was scary. I'm still scared of it.
Yeah, right.
All right, this famous artist dies in France.
Picasso?
Picasso. Yeah. Pablo Picasso. Meanwhile, I thought he died in like the 1800s, but that's not how much I know. The daughter of Queen Elizabeth gets married. What's her name?
I have no clue.
Princess Anne. Now, number the last one. This popular American daytime soap opera debuts. My grandma loves it.
Days of Our Lives?
No.
As the World Turns?
No.
Why do you know all these? Huh? I have no clue.
It's The Young
and the Restless.
My grandma loves this show.
Uh-huh.
I used to be obsessed with Days of Our Lives.
Steve, you're such a complicated individual.
John was possessed by the devil for a couple of seasons. It was very touch and go for a while. That's going to do it for the Steve Hatherly Show for this afternoon. I think that's still on air, too, Days of Our Lives.
I think they've been going on for like 50 years.
Yeah, right. Thanks for hanging out with us over the last couple of hours. Joel, thank you.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful happy birthday to you. Thank you very much. Yeah, we'll see you again next Monday. JY, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, as always, for your listenership and participation. And to finish it today, Daft Punk, Get Lucky. Enjoy the track. Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow. Hatherly out.